Hey there, YouTube. This video is for everybody, but it's mainly for two guys blindly playing games, aka Foggy Haze, the Monk Healer, and Skinrot, who I met on Reddit and were asking me questions about triggering custom sound effects in TellMeWhen. And right now I'm logged in with my Demon Hunter, Spect Vengeance, and you'll notice right off the bat it kind of looks like my UI is pretty clean, like pretty sparish. So I have 3x4 rows here. That's because I use a Venus Pro mouse, and I like what I see in-game to kind of reflect what I have in real life, which is why it's 3x4 rows. Skata, and I have a lot of stuff that's hidden. And the astute among you might have noticed that over here in the bottom left-hand corner, I got these tiny little icons. That's actually TellMeWhen, but I actually have quite a lot of TellMeWhen, so let me go ahead and make the back end available. And you'll see that there's quite a lot of stuff up here. This is a visual component to my setup, but we're not going to really talk about this too much because there's already a lot of videos on YouTube about how to set up TellMeWhen. We're going to be focusing on the custom sound effects, which is the stuff that I have down here. TellMeWhen allows you to have sound effect notifications for just about anything. And in order to access the notifications, all you got to do is click right here, this little notifications tab. And you can have text, you can have animation, you can have sound. It gives you a lot of different options. Like you can have sound on show, which I think is probably the most useful. And even if you don't have your own custom sound effects, there's a couple of things that come in come in standard. Some of them are pretty useless in my opinion, or just aesthetically awful, like this.
You will die.
Which, apart from not really cutting through the mix in the process of a fight, it's kind of confusing in my opinion to have, especially if you have a bunch of different characters and you assign a particular sound effect to be your notification for a major cooldown on, say, a Demon Hunter, and then use the same sound effect like on a Monk or something like that. You might, well, maybe you have a good memory, but maybe you'll forget like which sound effect means what, hence, the value of custom sound effects. And so right here, these are my custom sound effects that I got. Let's just go through them. Let's start with the sigils. We got Sigil of Flame, which makes this sound effect when it comes off cooldown. That's the main one. That cuts through really, really nice, and it kind of sounds offensive to me. That's the Sigil of Flame is the one that does damage. Sigil of Silence makes this sound effect. Originally, I kind of wanted kind of like that high-pitched ringing sound effect that you hear when you hear a loud sound. Let's get away from that guy because he's making a lot of noise. So I'm going to go over here. And so that nice high-pitched ringing sound cuts through, but it has a kind of an impact at the beginning. So it'll cut through in the process of a fight. Sigil of Misery, which is the fear, will make this sound effect, which is very horror movie to me. And so whenever I hear that, I instantly know that I can fear people because I heard the scary sound effect. Sigil of Change, which is the one that sucks people in, kind of like the mass grip of a death knight, makes this sound effect. It sounds like metal chains, and that's kind of what it does. It kind of really fits, in my opinion. And I got a lot of different sound effects. Sigil of Fiery Brand. Fiery Brand. To me, that sounds like a Fiery Brand. Demon Spikes makes that kind of like sound effect of metal blades scraping together, preparing for an attack. That's because the sound effect of when they come out, the actual in-game sound effect, is kind of like like a knife coming out. So that kind of evokes that, in my opinion. That's also the sound effect I used for Blade Dance when I played Havoc, which cuts through really nice as well. Immolation Aura makes this sound effect, which sounds like what it looks like to me, because it sounds like a bunch of like little fiery fragments going in different directions. So whenever I hear that, I know that I can do my Immolation Aura. This sound effect is something that I'm still experimenting with. On the Havoc side for Dash, I have this sound effect, which really sounds perfect for Dash. When I play Vengeance, I use that same sound effect just because, It's kind of like the equivalent spell. The Infernal Strike is kind of like the Dash equivalent when you play Vengeance. So I'm thinking of replacing that one later down the road with something that's maybe a little bit more bouncy sounding, or like maybe like an impact landing sound, maybe down the road, but it works for now. And for metamorphosis, I have this familiar sound effect. That's right. That's the Godzilla sound effect. Whenever I hear that, I know that I can do metamorphosis. I use that same sound effect when I play DPS, so I know I can do metamorphosis. Right now, I'm using a trinket called Lustrous Golden Plumage. The icon is like a little feather, and so I use this custom sound effect. And those are the main ones that I'm using right now for Vengeance. I have different sound effects for when I play Havoc, and I have different sound effects for Monk, and they're all unique. So, you know, I can switch between alts, and whenever I hear these unique sound effects, I don't get confused. If you were like using the custom, you know, tell me when sound effects like
die
or I mean, it, so long as you maybe were only using one sound effect per character, you maybe wouldn't get confused. It wouldn't get tired. But I like having a lot of sound effects. Like on this character alone, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 for Vengeance. And I probably have 10 unique ones for, well, not unique. There's some overlap, but 10 sound effects for Havoc as well. So it's important to me for them to be unique. Also, I have right here a kind of a, like a little mini pain bar right there. So when I get full pain, 100% pain, I hear that kind of cymbal crash, which lets me know that, hey, I reached 100 pain, so maybe it's time to start spending it, unless we're saving it for a special occasion or something. So that's all the sound effects. Let me kind of show you what it sounds like in practice. I'll go ahead and just open up with Metamorphosis, so maybe it'll come off cooldown. We'll tack this test dummy here. And right there, you can hear like I got full pain. Let me spend some sigils, even though we don't really need to. Let's just spend them, so we can start hearing them when they come off cooldown. So right there I heard the breaking sound, the sound of breaking glass, so I know I could do my immolation aura. Right there, I know that I can use my sigil of flame again. And like the whole point of this, I guess, is to basically be able to spend more time focusing on other things. If you can kind of get these audio cues to kind of subconsciously go into your brain, you know, you don't have to, at least I feel like I don't have to, you know, I can focus more attention on other things, like not standing in things. I never really thought about using these sound effects for the visually impaired or anything like that, but after kind of spending some time on Reddit, it kind of got me thinking that it could be useful if you like custom sound effects. So right now we're going to sigil chains off cooldown very soon. And there we hear it. We hear that chain sound effect. And then we heard a scary sound effect, so I know that I can silence, I mean, fear things again. That scary sound effect lets me know that I can... That fiery sound lets me know fire brands off cooldown. We still got about a minute until we can do metamorphosis, so we won't hear the Godzilla sound effect for a while. Now I know I can use my sigil of flame again. Right there, that sound effect lets me know I can silence again. So it's basically just knowing what I have, you know, letting you know what you have in your pocket. I know a lot of people use icons that kind of flash, like right on top of your screen, like right in the middle of the screen, you know, like when things come off cooldown. I don't know, if they like it, that's cool. I always found that distracting. You see that right here on the side, I just got these two little meters that are basically tracking the debuffs on the enemy for Spirit Bomb and Soul Cleave. Because I'm talented into the Soul Cleave. Right there, you heard that bird sound. So I know that I can use my trinket again. Let's go ahead and use the sigils. Let's go off cooldown for no reason. So 17 seconds, we're going to hear Godzilla letting me know metamorphosis is off cooldown. And I hear that I can silence things. And there we go, Godzilla. So now I know I got another metamorphosis and we can do it right there. Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's pretty much how that works. Let's run away. Yeah, so that's custom sound effects and Tell Me When. Like I say, you know, Tell Me When comes with a couple of standard sound effects. You know, if you only need like one or two sound effects, I guess that's okay. But, you know, I think the custom ones are way better. You can put basically whatever you want. This, you know, limited only by your imagination, as cheesy as that sounds. The only thing is Tell Me When only likes .ogg files, which are pretty easy to make. Like if you trim your audio like in some type of DAW or something like that, it's very easy to convert them to OGG file. And I've always found that mono files work best, but you can use stereo if you want to. I like keeping my sound effect notifications as mono just because there's a lot of things going on. And, you know, like in a fight, like a fight in World of Warcraft, sometimes if you're wearing headphones especially, you can tell which side things are coming at you from based upon whether or not it's coming more from the right side or the left side. And just having like your own personal sound effects coming from the middle kind of keeps them in a different space. So it kind of makes it easier to focus on. And is that anything else? No, I think that's about it. That's the sound effects. Like I say, it's a lot of fun to mess around with, and I would recommend anybody who's interested get involved in making their own custom sound effects. It's a lot easier than you would think in Tell Me When versus Weak Auras, which, you know, I know a lot of people are turned off by Weak Auras just because making your own custom setups in Weak Auras is kind of like a whole chore. In Tell Me When, you just Tell Me When is a little bit more limited in what it can do, but the setup is way easier. And especially if you're like me and you just want things to trigger sound effects and you don't really care what it looks like, which is one of the limitations of Tell Me When, you only care what it sounds like, then Tell Me When, you know, might be perfect for you. So hope you guys enjoyed the video, and yeah, I'll see you guys in Azeroth. Have a good night.